Rabbits got out well, but it was a little windy. I think a lot of people were a little hesitant to go with it, but Garrett is a fearless racer, and he got right on him. I was behind Will Lear in about fifth or so, and he got gapped a little bit, and I had to work really hard that second lap to cover it. And then I just sat on Garrett and let him do the work, unfortunately, for that's how racing is. Sorry. But then, with 150 to go, I just made a hard move. I felt good and went for it. I knew the finish line was really close up. So the 200 isn't where you think it is. You have a lot less left than you think. So it was good. Really, really happy with the summer and just the way things were going. Just got sponsored by Hoka 1-1 and been wearing their jersey proudly.
Wearing the spikes now, too?
Not yet. We're just in a prototype phase. By next indoor season, I'll have some custom Hoka 1-1 spikes or something awesome. But yeah, they're working hard to be a full company and full range of everything and flats and spikes, and their trainers are great. And they're fully committed to the sport track field, which has been a pleasure to work with so far.
Yeah. So kind of breakdown so far this year. Do you attribute that to being healthy again, or why do you think it is that you've
I attribute the majority of that to Coach Gagliano and our physio, Tommy Nohilly. I'm just healthy, and I was beat up for a little bit indoors, but that was actually a cross-training injury. But guys kept me healthy and kept my mind in the right place the whole year, and he's been incredible. And New Jersey, New York's been an incredible group to work with.
David Garrett, I mean, he said that you did all the work. I mean, what was it like for you guys?
Well, for me, I was watching Garrett up front, and even Kyle up there. I was way towards the back. I think we're all surprised that gap opened up. Everyone seemed to be in really good shape this summer, and when that opened up, I saw Kyle go second lap, and I thought about moving, but I waited to the third lap. So, it was just kind of a weird race today. Like, the wind died down, I thought we'd really get after it, but, like Kyle said earlier, it doesn't always play out that way, and so glad to get in a good race before he was checking out to Europe again, and really thankful to Falmouth for putting on this event, and, giving a shot at another domestic meet for us U.S. milers to really put on a show, because I think the U.S. behind Kenya really is the number two miling nation in the world. So whenever we can put on a show like this for fans, it's always a good opportunity for us and the fans.
Did you think you had it there for a while?
David said there wasn't much wind, but honestly, I thought there was.
I was in the back, so I didn't feel any of it.
No, I guess like my strength has always been running from the front a little bit, or my weakness, depending on how you look at it. And today I kind of promised myself I was going to sit back a little bit, but sure enough, I was like out in third, and the pace went out pretty hard, and I heard somebody shout over there that there was like a 15-meter gap or 15-foot gap, or there was a gap, and I was like, well, maybe I should just go now. And then I was I was kind of having an internal battle and decided to wait and wait, and then finally with about 800 to go, Donnie started to fall off the rabbit a little bit, and I was like, all right, well, I'll get on Danny and follow him and try to move with like 400 or 500 alone and see what I can do. And as soon as I got on Danny, he dropped out, and I was like, it figures. I felt good, and I kept waiting for one of these guys to come around me with like 300 to go and 200 to go, and at that point, you're like, man, I'm tying up, but maybe nobody's coming. And then I started to hear this guy on my outside, and I was like, oh, this is it. This is it. Time to go. But it was awesome. It's all about, being the fastest and running the smartest. And, Kyle had the both of those today. So it was really fun. This race is always great. And the crowds here were a lot bigger than I remember being last year even. So should be a fun weekend.
Right. Hey, thanks, guys.
Actually, after the end of the race, that come around the bend, you guys are both tracking Garrett. It's a weird finish, but it's right in the middle. Did that factor into your decision making at all? The fact that you had to move like sooner than you had to normally?
In the past it has. I remember my first time I ran here, I consciously kicked earlier than normal because I knew that it was a short straightaway. So if I was in the front on the straightaway, I'd have a good shot of holding everyone off. But then the second year I tried that, and I still blew up the last 50. And 50 meters is still a long time to die, and you can still get past a lot of people. So this time I was like, I'm just gonna wait, just really feel it out, feel the race. And I just kind of followed. So I think when you're really on, that makes a difference, trying to get in there a little earlier and get to the front. But today, I think I'm just not as sharp as some of these guys. You know, I didn't race it much in the first half of the summer, and you know, this is my first race since late July. So yeah, I think I'm on the right path and kind of heading the better direction than I was in most of June, early July. So
yeah, I mean, it's just that are you more adjusted with the new training group? Like, where are you training out of now?
So I'm still training out of California. I trained with Jama in June and also in July, and at the end of July we kind of had a long talk and figured out, like, you know, I always kind of assumed to, like, just do the work, you know. Yeah, you're in this group and if you're with everybody you're gonna get better, you know. But in talking with Jama, I was like, you know what, I'm not one of those coaches that you have to do everything I tell you to do, you know, to the letter, to every little point. He's like, I want you to talk to me, I want you to, like, give me feedback, and, like, if you feel uncomfortable with something, let me know. And so, you know, as a new athlete in a group, you don't want to question too many things and kind of be, you know, that kind of pain or whatever. So I kind of held my thoughts back a little bit, but we now have a better understanding in how to work together and, you know, yeah, produce some good results. So I'm really happy where things are going, and I'm looking forward to the second half.
Yeah, you got anything else coming up?
My next race will be the Stockholm 800. And the B race, and after that, I believe Birmingham. We're like crossing our fingers that works out, and then I think Berlin, Zagreb, Rieti, and then Fifth Ave. So I have a pretty full second half.
All right, appreciate the time.